Hey everyone, welcome to the new session, Predict Your Beer Consumption Capacity Using ML. It will be a very interesting session as, before start the session, let me introduce that Great Learning has come up with a brilliant idea, that is Great Learning Academy, where you will get almost 80 plus free courses, and after complete your course, you can claim your certificate as well. And if you want to do these courses in a mobile application, that is also possible using Great Learning app. And please let me know in the live chat I am audible or not. If I am audible, then please put a yes comment, for that we can start the session. And yes, let me introduce that, I'm Shyampriti from Great Learning, right? So give me a quick confirmation, and also I will wait for the other folks to join to the session, and then we will start to the session, right? Okay, I will wait for a few seconds, and in the meantime, give me that confirmation that I am audible or not. And also, how many of you have idea about machine learning? Because in today's session, we are going to do the demo part mostly. We will do a Q&A and we will do this talking about the ML. Talking about the ML concepts as well. So, and I want this session to be more interactive, right? Yes. So, I am just waiting for a few more seconds to wait. Just waiting for the other folks to join the session. Okay, I can see lots of yes. How many of you have idea about machine learning? Yes, right. Ravi is saying I have some idea. Okay, I want more answer, guys. This session to be more interactive. Yes. Someone is saying is basic. Okay. Vaiva is saying I know about ML concepts. That's really nice. Then you will quite enjoy the session. And if you don't have, then also it's fine, because we are going to do the from scratch. I mean, what is machine learning? What is everything? And then we will jump to demo. And today we will do the Q&A as well. So this is why I'm just in a little hurry to start the session quickly. Yes. Some idea. I have some idea. ML by Python. Kandi Kanti. Okay, that's really nice. Okay, I hope all joined. Okay, Arindam is saying, sir or ma'am, please make a video on detecting Parkinson's disease using XGBoost. Maybe we will come up with the session. It's a good idea. So why don't you guys give us the idea in the comment, not in the live chat. So after the live chat, after the live session, I can just go through it. What are the thing you want from us to do the live sessions? Maybe we will come up with that. So please give your ideas as well to the comment section, right? To the comment section, and let us know what you want to learn from us. Yes, we are going to do algorithm as well, right? Without algorithm, we cannot make machine learning, right? Yes. So yeah, if you really like the session, please do the like hit the like button, for that I can understand you are liking the session. So let's get started with today's session, right? First, we are going to talk about why do we need machine learning. Then we will jump into what is machine learning, and then we will have a talk about what is the life cycles to build a model in machine learning. Then we will talk about what is machine learning. Already we have listed it. Okay. Then we will have a talk about what is the difference between typical programming and machine learning. Then we will talk about the types of machine learning we have, right? Which algorithm we are going to use, linear regression today. And then we will do a project on predict beer consumption using linear regression, right? Okay. So we will always encourage your ideas to do the session. Maybe with a very short time, we will come up with the session ideas that you are going to give us. I hope we will get some all these sessions idea and doing all these things just to help you guys, just to solve your doubts. So if you give us idea that what you want to learn from us, so that will be always be a great opportunity for us to help you on that topics. So please do let your ideas know about the comment section, not in the live chat, because it's not possible for me to after the live session to go for all the live chat. But please do this after the live session in the comment section. For that we can come up with this tutorials you want, right? Okay, So let's have a look at why do we need machine learning, right? So I can see some of you have idea about what is machine learning, why do we need machine learning, right? Yes, Rahit, we are going to provide the downloadable file, whatever the session material we are going to use over here, right? Okay. Yes, before start the machine learning, what do you think about that? What's the difference between traditional programming and machine learning? I mean, why do we need machine learning and why every companies, right? Yes, Rahit, I think I just gave you answer, right? Okay. So what do you think every company is like, why this craze of a data scientist or a machine learning engineer or a data analyst? I mean, what do you think? Why this is in so high demand and everyone wants to learn it? I mean, I just want to understand your thoughts. Why do you think, like, why they are actually booming in this? You know, if you talk about this pandemic situations as well, still they are actually booming, right? So why do you think that in the case of pandemic situation when everything is like shutting down, that time also a data science is in a, you know, data science domain or a data science concept is in a big booming, like, you know, big booming options. So what do you think about it? Just give me just a random thoughts I'm just sharing with you. I mean, just why do you think that why machine learning or data science are booming right now? Give me a quick answer. In the meantime, I will start doing this. Why do we need machine learning? So in the past, we used to have data. Okay. So let me give you an analogy or a scenario for that you can understand why do we need machine learning. So if we talk about something Zomato, Swiggy, Ola, Uber, I mean, we are quite used to with these apps, right? So in that case, Gautam is saying gain knowledge. Okay, fine. Let me just complete this slide and I will come back to your answers, guys. Okay. So why do you think that like we are quite used to with Ola, Uber or, you know, Swiggy, Zomato. Every time if I need to have some food, I just go to Zomato or Swiggy. I just order my food. So every time when you are actually making the order or we are going to, you know, like ordering your cab or anything, whatever you are going to do online, the like respective companies are going to take those data. But why they are taking your data? What will happen? Like what food you are ordering, where you are going, why do they want to take it? Because they want to take it to understand a person's nature, right? If you are someone who is going to do, like, maybe you are a burger person, or maybe you are a Chinese person, or you love to have biryanis, right? So in that case, it's a recommending thing, right? So as we can see in Amazon, whatever we buy in the past, according to that, those companies are used to give us, like, maybe you can like it, right? In the Facebook also, there is like, maybe you know this person. Okay, so from the start, from Swiggy, Zomato, Amazon, everyone is using your data to give you some other options to buy or go for checking them out. Why they are doing that? What they will get from that? So if they know that you are a burger person or you are a Chinese, you love to have Chinese or you love to have biryanis, so they will suggest you some good places where you can try biryanis. If you like it, what will happen? The sale will happen, right? So similarly, as the recommendation part works, similarly, if they can see, okay, in this particular restaurant, this dishes are getting more popularity and ordered by lots of people. So maybe we can do one thing. We can just, you know, give some rebate on this. Then the sales will increase. So forecasting of sales, right? So this is how this data are getting used. So what we used to have in the past, we used to have a data in a structured format. Why? A person, right? Suppose a person is going to do all the data part, okay? And he's going to insert all the data. Obviously, the data will be in a structured format. But as time change, as we are going towards an online world or, you know, digital India, we can say. So in that time, what's happening? We are doing lots of online transactions, right? As we are increasing the online transactions, that time, what's happening? Every time you are doing an online transaction, you are going for any shopping, you are doing any online food ordering or cab, that time that particular company is trying to fetch the data, right? Not even the data, they are trying to fetch your from where you are locating, right? If you know about Google Analytics, what they does, they actually take, suppose you are going to buy a lots of t-shirts, right? So lots of the companies are using Google Analytics as well. So how this Google Analytics works is just a, you know, it's just giving you a short overview of that. So there is a JavaScript code will be there, and this code will start working on the your e-commerce website. Okay. So what's happening? They are trying to fetch from where are you from, what is your IP address, what are from what region you are belong to. So suppose in India there is a, maybe in Kolkata or in Bangalore, whatever the place you want to take, maybe I can take from Kolkata. So there is a, most of the people, they love to have biryani, right? So they can understand, okay, in this region, if we can give some more, emphasizing on Indian foods or North Indian foods, that time it will get more, more of our sales will be happening. So basically, at the end of the day, we try to focus the sales, okay? So now what we are having, a lots of data. With a few hours, if you can think of our populations, right? So lots of data we are, the companies are generating. But the problem is those data are not in a structured way. They are semi-structured or unstructured. So how can a company is going to handle those unstructured data when they know about only the structured format? What are the traditional format we have? The traditional format only known how to process a structured data. They don't know how to process an unstructured data in a huge manner, right? So this is where machine learning and data science concepts comes into the picture. So data science help us to do what? Data science help us to process those unstructured data. When you process those unstructured data and make them in a structured way, that time machine learning comes into the picture. And machine learning with their algorithms help us to make our model. Right? Okay. So this is where the machine learning comes into the picture. And this machine learning algorithm help us to make a model. That model will work for us. How? Suppose you are going to say, hey, please focus my sales. That time your model is going to focus your data or focus your sales using the past data. Right? So this is where, this is the reason why data science and machine learning are booming right now. Not right now, upcoming year also, it's gonna boom, because the main reason is it's giving you insights from this unusable data, right? It's just using those data who are not usable, okay? So those data you are generating anyway. So if you are getting a proper insights, a proper reason, how can you focus your business, right? So you can use them, right? So this is the reason why do we need machine learning, right? Now I will look at your answers and then we will move towards the next part. What is machine learning? Okay, so I can see Gautam is saying gain knowledge from data. Yes, Gautam, you are right. Ravi is saying machine can learn itself. Yes, machine can learn itself. Okay, now Lakshman is saying pandemic generated more data, hence data scientists are in demand. Kind of right, Lakshman. It's true that pandemic is basically what is happening. There are lots of changes are happening, and in the reason of the changing, there are lots of prediction is coming up, and that time they are preferring to use data science. Yes, pandemic is one of the reason, and generating new data, new trends, and we can understand. I mean, we never knew that we can go for work from home for so long, right? So this is also a part that data scientists are trying to analyze what are the new normal, right? New normal are going to happen. So that time also they are quite trying to understand the analogies from the data scientist, right? Okay. Then Gautam is saying our buying nature. Yeah, that's true. We are becoming more online person. Okay. Right. So guys, what do you think about whatever we have talked so far? Manish, no, machine learning, deep learning and AI are not same. They are related fields. If you want to learn more about it, why don't you go and check it out, our video on machine learning versus deep learning versus AI. Machine learning versus data science versus AI. Our moderator will send that link. In machine learning is learning from the data. Yes, Abhishek, in machine learning we learn from data itself. How update is working in machine learning? What updates you are talking about, Pirate? I didn't get it. Okay, so what do you think? What we have talked about, why do you need machine learning? What do you think? Do you understand why do we need machine learning? Can we go for what is machine learning? Give me a quick update on that. That yes, you understood why do we need machine learning. I try to give more of a industry scenarios because I feel like when I started learning, that time what I feel, if someone is going to give me a proper idea of industry, where can I use them? That will make me, like, that will help me a lot. So in the case of my session, when I'm trying to deliver my knowledge to you, so that time I try to give some industry experience or industry ideas that where actually we are going to use them, right? Okay, I can see Ravi is saying yes, Seth is saying yes. Okay, I want this session to be more interactive, guys. That's not the fair thing, right? I try to interact with you all. Yes, Vikash, we are going to work on a project, right? So what is machine learning? Machine learning is a subset of artificial intelligence, right? And as we talked about, it is a part of AI that allows the system to automatically learn. Obviously, it's going to learn automatically and improve experience without being explicitly programmed. So you don't need to program every time. First time, you need to give the data, you need to make a model, and that's all. And then you need to say, hey, our model is working fine. And whenever you got the new data, please provide to your model and your model will work for you. This is what a machine learning is in a layman term, right? Now we are going to talk about what is the difference between traditional programming versus machine learning. So as we say, traditional programming and machine learning. So why don't you give me the reason that what is the difference between traditional programming and machine learning? And in the meantime, I will give the answers. And why don't you give me the reasons? I can see some of you are actually I saw you in the previous session as well. I have discussed about traditional programming and machine learning programming. Why don't you give me some points, whatever you understood? Then I can start talking about traditional versus machine learning. You know, peer-to-peer learning is the best thing to learn. Yes. Okay, predicting and enhancing sales, Subhashkar, right? ML will help in time series data. Yes, time series is one of the part of machine learning. So what do you think, that weather forecasting, sale forecasting, any forecasting, we try to use deep learning or else we use time series analysis, right? Abhishek, what you want to learn from scratch, if you can just give me that idea. Avtar is asking, ma'am, how can I start and learn ML? Why don't you check out our lots of course? Our moderator is already sending the links. Why don't you go and check them out? Free of cost, you can get the certificate and you also can learn from ML. I can give you the guarantee, you will love it, right? Okay. Ramanan, briefly about decision tree. Okay, decision tree. Okay, in the later in the section, we will talk about that, right? Cool. Okay, right. So now we are going to talk about the difference between traditional programming and machine learning. So what is machine learning and, okay, what is traditional programming? Jashwant is asking. So traditional programming, the way we write our program, I mean, just giving our input, you getting the output, right? Maybe you are giving two numbers and you will get the average of two numbers, sum of two numbers. I'm giving the very basics idea, right? So this is what our traditional programming. So every time you give the data, you do programming and get the output. But in the case of machine learning, what you will do, you will get the data, you will make your model and you will get the output. But in the second time, whenever you are going to get a data, a new data, that time you don't need to go for doing the programming. What you need to do, just say your model, hey, I give you some new data and work for me. And your model will work for you. And it's reducing the human efforts. It's reducing the human cost. I mean, if you have someone who do the programming for you every time, it's cost, right? So if your model, someone is going to make your model and then your model will start working for you, that will be not costly, right? Not that much costly. Yes. So in that case, the machine learning is basically reducing the human effort, helping to, you know, saving the time and the resources as well, right? So this is the difference between traditional versus machine learning, right? Okay, I can see, ma'am, what is traditional programming? I gave the answer, Jashwant. programmers are needed every time? Yes, programmers are needed, but for one particular project, you can use a one particular resource for multiple projects, right? So this is how machine learning is helping us. Yes, we can tune the model in ML, Tamil, right? Now we are going to talk about what? We are going to talk about the life cycles to build a model with machine learning. So today we are going to do very less, that learning part. What we are going to do? We are going to do the demo. Okay, right. Manish, it's up to you to learn ML properly. It will take 1 month for sure. Right, if you know if you know Python very well, so it will take at least 1 month to learn machine learning from scratch. Right, now we are going to talk about the life cycles to build a model with machine learning. Again, guys, if you really like the video, then please do hit like the like button. And this is not fair. I just want to see how many of you are actually liking the video. Okay, now we are going to talk about the life cycle of our building a model with machine learning. First, we need to understand the business problem. Why do we need to understand the business problem? Again, let's go back to the scenario, right? It will. What do you want? Should I make it more practical way, in a industrial way, how we do the analogy with the analogy, with the, or just the explanation? What do you want? Give me a quick confirmation, and according to that, I will start making you understand that how a machine learning model, how can you make a machine learning model, right? So give me a quick confirmation, what you want? You want me to give you the proper scenario where you can start using the building a stage of machine learning, or Akshit is saying, okay, hi Akshit, okay, sorry Akshat, okay, I'm so sorry. That's really nice that you know Python. Raghav, for job perspective, there are lots of sessions we have. Why don't you go and check them out? Ma'am, are you going to explain the math behind linear regression? Yes, we are going to do that. Akshat, I give you the answer. Okay. Data manipulation, yes, we are going to do. Industrial way. Vashkar is also saying analogy makes sense. Akshat, I give you the answer. Industrial way. So, most of you wants in an industrial way. Let me just make these things as an industrial way. Okay. So, understand the business problem. Suppose you are in Swiggy or Zomato or any web applications, right? You are in that, and you are the data scientist. They will ask you, hey, our sales is actually going down, and you need to do something to, make our sales, or just try to focus our sales, as well as we just want to increase our sales as well, right? So, in that case, how can you do that? So in that case, you are the data scientist, you have data, and you have nothing else, and they are like, we don't know anything, we just want to increase our sales. So what you can do, you can just go and check the data. Maybe in the data you can see, okay, there are something we can go for recommending people, or there are something we can go for, okay, maybe giving some rebate. How can you do that? So your business perspective is try to increase the sales, or try to make understand what or the sentiment of the customers. This is the best word we can use. The sentiment of the customers, what will what will go well with your customers. First, you need to try to understand your customers, right? Now, when you know what is your business perspective, that your business your objective is basically try to build a good customer base, as well as try to make a good sales. Okay, this will be your business problem. Then comes the data acquisitions. So when we talk about data acquisitions, data acquisition is basically collecting the data. So when you have a pretty much fair enough of data, you know, okay, I have a good amount of data, what company provide me, or if you go for some other repository, you can check that data out. But you have data, but again, those data are in a structured or a semi-structured way. What you need to do? You need to clean those data. How can you clean them? Maybe you will say, okay, this is just a cleaning part, I don't need to do lots of things, right? But cleaning is taking the most time, most of the time, trust me. So what you need to do, you will go, you will check your data, you will understand what are the attributes really needed for your data, right? From Akshat, from scratch, I can understand you want to learn from scratch, but for that our moderator are giving you the link. Why don't you go and check that out? Please don't spam in the section, guys. If you do spam, then our moderator will block you. Don't do that. I mean, I try to make this session more interactive because I try to solve your doubts more, right? So don't do that. Okay, Kajal is saying, madam, desktop not showing. What is not showing? I can see this PPT and everything is showing, right? Okay, so when we talk about the data cleaning, there are lots of things comes under that. So maybe you have some, there is no value, something. Suppose you are going to talk about the user sentiment, you are going to say that what is the customer's region. According to that, maybe you are going to group them. That time you have some column called is the person. Okay, that profession is also matters. So some of the case, maybe what is the birthday is also needed, because in the birthday maybe you can give some good offer to the customers. Some column will be there, maybe where this person is graduate or not, right? What is the qualification of the person? Maybe that is also working, but I'm just trying to give you an answer. So in that case, maybe you see some of the attributes is just not needed, right? So that time what you will do, you will say, hey, I don't want this attribute. I don't want to make my model with a too heavy data. I am going to delete it. Or there are lots of NaN values will be there. You want to delete them. How can you do that? Using data cleaning. Removing the data which is not needed for your model. Removing the NaN values or the missing values. Removing the attributes in a proper way and try to make your attributes in a proper way. Right, so basically you are making a unusable data to a usable part. So this is what data cleaning stands for. Then when your data is already in a structured way, your data is ready to go, and it's like, okay, I did the data cleaning part, now what I need to do, I need to go for the exploratory data analysis. So what is exploratory data analysis? Exploratory data analysis is basically a stats concepts. It will help you to use a stat concepts to understand your data. So what we are going to understand, already we cleaned the data, right? So understanding the data, maybe you can see what is the count of your data. Maybe in the description, you can see what is the interquartile range of your data. These are the stats terms. As you know, the stats and linear algebra are the basic pillars for data science, right? So you have lots of functions in Python. You can directly use them, right? Vashkar is saying, please suggest any tools for data cleaning. Maybe in the later in the section, I will help you out on that. Right? Yes, Rajesh, it's 80% of the time goes into data cleaning. Right? When your data is basically clean, you can use statistical terms to understand your data. Right? You don't need to go for doing lots of things. Okay, so you don't need to go for lots of things. What you will do? Now you will use the statistical concepts. You will go for, okay, I will go for statistical concepts. I will see what is the count of the, what is the count of our data? What is this range? When we talk about the data range is basically how your data is, how your data is structured, okay? How your datas are, you can see them, right? So data range, what is the interquartile range, what is the standard deviations, right? All those things can be done in the data exploratory data analysis. After you do the data exploratory data analysis, what you will do, you say, okay, I know my data. I don't need anyone to say, hey, you need to go for using this algorithm or you need to go for using this algorithm, right? As you know your data, you will go for machine learning algorithms. So in the machine learning algorithm, we have few types of machine learning algorithm. We will talk about that as well. So in the machine learning algorithm, we will say, okay, this is the types, there is the three types we have, and from there I am going to use this algorithm, right? So this is how you are going to make your model. When you make your model, then you need to predict your model. So predicting model is basically using new data, you can predict your model. After you see in the new data your model is working pretty fine, pretty fair enough, that time you say, hey, I want to deploy my model. what to deploy? You are deploying model basically. Some other person can also use your model, and in the cloud or in the sub websites, you can deploy your model. So this is the whole scenario of making a model with machine learning. So I hope you have a clear idea. So let me give you a quick confirmation on that, and then we will talk about types of machine learning, and then we will jump into the project. Give me a quick confirmation on that. How many of you understand the process of making a model in using ML? Right. Okay, I can see some of the question. Gautam, you are asking this data mostly on Excel or any other platform. I don't understand your question, Gautam. Right. Manish, yes, you can go and check that out in Kaggle. And Kaggle, in Kaggle, if you go for the competitions and if you start competing, the good companies will come and like say you, hey, can you please join our company, as you are really good on Kaggle and you know the data, how to process all of them. Meera, that's really nice that you have just started ML. Please go on, keep on doing that, and please do let me know what you feel about ML, right? Yes, right. Now we are going to talk about types of machine learning. What are the types we have? We have supervised learning, unsupervised learning, and reinforcement learning, right? So what is supervised learning? So supervised learning is basically, there will be a supervisor. You will have a teacher. And your teacher is basically going to say, hey, this is right, this is wrong. Okay, so when you have a teacher, yes, Ravi, we are going to do that, right? You need to stay tuned for that, okay? So when you have a teacher, your teacher is going to help you. How can you learn? In the case of unsupervised learning, what will happen? There will be no teacher. In the, I think you can see the images, right? Okay, so in the image itself, you can see. Okay, in the image itself, you can see that machine start learning by itself. So this is the where unsupervised and supervised learning comes into the picture. So supervised learning, we work with the labeled data. Unsupervised learning, we work with the unlabeled data. I will show you what is that labeled and unlabeled means. Akshat, please don't spam in the section. Then again, our moderator is gonna block you. Don't do that. This is a request for you guys. There are real good questions I am getting and I am trying to answer them. Gautam, our data can be stored in a CSV format, in Excel and other platform as well. What you did not understand, Manish? What the last thing you did not understand? Okay, right. So here you can see on the unsupervised learning, you will have an unlabeled data. Or in the case of reinforcement learning, what will happen? Model will start learning from reward. Yeah, your model will start learning from reward and from the penalty. So if your model is going to do well, you are going to give a reward. If your model is going to do, hey, my model is working badly, then you are going to give the penalty. This is how reinforcement learning works. Akshat, I think your question is not relevant to the session. Right. Now, what we are going to talk about? We are going to talk about the supervised learning. As we already talked about, supervised learning is actually... Okay. So, Badri is asking about reinforcement learning with example. So, how many of you know about Tesla self-driving car? How many of you know about... How many of you know about Tesla self-driving car? Yes, Ravi, I just said to Akshat that only. Okay, which are the other platforms? What other platforms you are talking about? You can store your data on cloud, on database, anywhere. Abhishek, there are lots of opportunity you will get being a fresher. Trust me if you know how to solve it. Okay. Ma'am, deleted file restore is not done. I don't understand, Kajal, what you are saying. Shubham, please don't spam in the section, spam in the chat. Yes. Guys, don't spam. I'm trying to figure it out your question and try to answer your questions. Do not spam, please. Okay. So, supervised learning, work as a supervisor. Okay. And you will have a teacher over there. Okay. So, how many of you, yeah, yes, I can get that answer that you understand about Tesla, right? Okay, so if you know Tesla, Tesla is a reinforcement learning project, right? So Tesla self-driving car, what will happen? So in that, it will start learning like how to do the self-driving. How they can do that? Basically, what they do, they actually do... Sorry, guys. Okay. Okay. So what they do, basically, they actually do... when your data, when your model is saying, okay, there will be a blockage, right? Your model say, oh, okay, I know there will be a blockage. It's going to give you a reward that, okay, your model is learning perfectly. When your model is know there is a blockage and going to drive the car very badly, that time you are going to give a penalty, right? So this is how Tesla self-driving cars works. And this is one of the main example of reinforcement learning. Guys, for your spamming in the section, then I will just, like, I don't know, I will overlook the questions who are really needed. I mean, they want the answer, right? Don't do that. So, in the supervised learning, what's happening? In the supervised learning, we talk there will be a teacher. So, in the learning from the label data and applying the knowledge to predict the label of the new data. We are going to do on that. We are going to do a project over here right away. So the types of supervised learning we have linear regression, logistic regression, decision tree, random forest, mean forest. So basically types of machine learning algorithm, or if you talk about types of supervised learning, we have classification and regression, right? Now what we are going to do, we are going to talk about linear regression. But before talking about linear regression, let's go to demo and let's do the demo first, okay? How many of you are actually excited to do the demo? Let me know. I just want to know how many of you want to do the demo. I mean, you can see this is a beer consumption prediction. Okay. How many of you know about Google Colab, guys? I just want to know how many of you have idea about Google Colab. So if you don't know about Google Colab, then I should suggest you go for our Google Colab tutorial to learn about that. Penalty means, how can I make you understand? Okay, so you did something wrong. I said, as you did something wrong, for that I am not gonna give you food. This is something penalty, you can check that out. Like this is a Ramana, this is a penalty. I mean, for there is some penalty we will put in the machine, our model. Okay, how do we know it's supervised and unsupervised? Good question, Manish. We are going to talk about that. Gunpreet is saying, join this only for this. Okay, I can see you guys who are really exciting to do that. Okay, so Google Colab, I hope you all know how to do Google Colab. So Google Colab, I'm not going to show you how you are going to use Google Colab, right? Okay, so what is this data all about? As we know, beer is one of the most democratic and consumed drinks in the world. Not without reason, it's perfect for almost every situation, right? From happy hour to large wedding parties. If you just think about it, you already feel like having a beer, you are not alone, right? The truth is that around the world, thousands of people consume drink regularly and also in different situations. But have you ever stopped to think about which countries are the most consuming beer in the world? Did you? Okay, the first one of the came to your head was Germany. Well, no, that is not so. The answer to the question is resounding that according to the research by the Japanese beverage company Kirin, the country has topped the per capita beer drinking table for 23 consecutive years in 2015. The most recent years for these statistics are available. Right, the Seizengs drank 142.4 liters per person. Can you even imagine? Right. Yes. So that's the equivalent of 250 pins, right? On every 35 hours. But given that minors are unlikely to be contributing to the figure, it's safe to assume the average beer drinker probably guzzles quite a bit more. Snapping at the seas at Republic's hills are the usual pretenders. Australia and Germany come third and fourth. Poland sixth and the Ireland seventh. There are some surprises, however, in the second place in the a lofty ranking, which we will put down to the hot climate and the larger number of holy marks. Right. So this is the whole data set is all about we are going to talk about, right? So in the data sample were collected from in Sao Paulo, Brazil, in the university area, and where there are some parties with group of students from 18 to 28 years of age. So this is the data set we are going to talk about, okay? The data set used for actively 7 attributes being targeted with a period of 1 year, okay? Right, so this is how, this is the data set we are going to talk about. So this data set you will get in the Kaggle itself, right? Beer consumption or beer data set in Sao Paulo, right? Yes. Okay, right, yeah. Now we are going to use some of the libraries. We are going to use NumPy, Pandas. Why do we use NumPy? NumPy is a numerical Python, right? So we use NumPy for numerical purposes. We are going to use Pandas for data manipulation. We are going to use DateTime to make our data to into like converting to DateTime. We use Seaborn. Some of you ask me why you are going to use Seaborn. Seaborn we are going to use because yes, I am going little fast because we are going to complete our session within 15 minutes. So for that, I think it's not going to make you trouble. I think it's just we are talking about the beer and the data set, right? So it's not, if you are not a beer person, you will not like it that much, right? Yeah. So yes, now what we are going to use? We are going to use Seaborn and Matplotlib. Why we are going to use Seaborn and Matplotlib? For the data visualizations. And scikit-learn we use for confusion metrics and machine learning purposes, right? Okay, so what quiz are you talking about? I don't understand. We are going to use Python over here, right? Yes, Kaggle has these data, so why don't you go and check that out? Yes, now what I have done, I have take this data to the Dropbox and I have already saved over there and I am just fetching from the link, right? So for that we are going to use wget function. So wget function we are going to use because it's help us to fetch the data from any given link. You can fetch the data from Kaggle itself using wget in Google Colab, right? So you can see over here, let me just execute this and this. Okay, as our data is num consumos cerveja. Okay, fine, I am not that good at like this part. Okay, so in the beer data we are going to make a variable called beer data where we are going to use pandas and we are going to use .read CSV function to read the CSV data, right? So as you can see in the beer data variable we got our data. If we can use dot head function, so when we use dot head function, what we do in the dot head function, we get first 5 rows. It will return you first 5 rows of your data set. Let me just execute this. Okay, so this is our data. Now if you want to see what are the columns we have, right? So just to try to see what are the columns we have, just put dot columns, right? If you just write dot columns and there you will get what are the columns you have. I have data, temperature media, temperature minima, temperature maxima, precipitação, final day semana, all these things, right? So yes, we have these columns. Now if you want to go for doing the dot shape, this dot shape is going to say how many rows and how many columns you have. We have 941 rows and 7 columns. Now comes the data evaluation, or you can say exploratory data analysis part. Dipanshu, what happened? We actually upload the data to Dropbox, right? When you upload the data to Dropbox, what will happen? It will give you a shareable link. From that link, you can directly download the data. Right. Now we are going to use dot describe function. In the dot describe, what you will get in the dot describe is going to give you count, mean, standard deviation, maximum, 25% IQR, 75% IQR, 50% IQR. So this is the what we are going to use dot describe function to describe your data set. Rohit, to get the data set, to get the CSV file. Okay, to get the CSV file, you need to go to Kaggle, right? Okay, now what we are going to do, we are going to check is there any NaN value is there or not. Manish, this is a Brazilian data set basically. So, we will make these changes, that's not a problem. We are going to work with that, right? Okay, fine. So, we are going to check is there any NaN value or the missing value is there or not. To check that, we are going to use dot isNA function. So, we have our data, beer data, then we are going to use dot isNA function to check is there any NaN values is there or not. And then we are going to use dot any, right? Let me just execute that. They say no, there are no missing values are there. Your data is actually good to go. Now there is for the null columns, again if you want to see what are the null values you have and the percentage, right? So number of null values and percentage you will get over here. Now if you say, hey, if I have any NaN values, then please drop that. How to do that? Write beer data dot drop any, then in place equals to true. It's basically we use drop any function to if you have any rows with NaN values, then please drop it. We don't want that. Now we are going to, as you can see, there are lots of strings are there, right? If you can see, there is a comma, right? What we can say, hey, I don't want comma, I want to make them as dot, right? So we use dot replace function to make those comma to point, right? So this is how we are going to use beer data dot replace comma, that is going to replace with dot. Rejects is equals to true. These are the rejects we called as, and in place equals to true. Let me just execute that. Now, as we have data, in that data, we are going to make those data as a, let me just print that beer data dot height, right? What's gonna give you? It's gonna say when you have data, these datas are basically date, right? So we just change those data to a date. How to do that? Called pandas dot. Okay, we are going to do pd dot to date time, right? So we are going to do what? We are changing our data columns. Okay, we are changing our data columns to date time, right? So for that pd dot date time, and which column, which particular column you want to change to date time, right? Okay, I can see lots of questions, guys. I will come back to you. Before that, I just want to complete this project. As you all are here to learn this project, right? This is really an interesting project because I do love having beer. So if I know if something is happening with beer, I would love to go for it, right? Yes. Now, as we can see, the date time is we are going to use to date time. Now, as we are saying that days, what do you have? We have Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday and Sunday. And we are trying to figure it out that in what day the beer consuming is high. A CSV file, Badri, you will get in Kaggle. Sandariya, thank you Sandariya. Thank you so much that you feel this session is helpful session. And again, if you want to get connected with Great Learning, then please go and go to our Great Learning Academy and you will get lots of new courses we have launched. And if you do that, you will get your certificate. And the second thing is like, do subscribe Great Learning to get notification for new videos, right? Okay. Now, as we can see the days, okay, days is like Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday. We are going to make a column called days, right? Okay. Now, in the day, what we are going to do, we are going to use a lambda function. what lambda function we are going to say? We are say beer data, that the data one that we have make this to date. So we are going to say days dot weekdays, right? So whatever date, as it's already a date, so if your date is saying, okay, this is a date, so what are the weekdays? Make it weekday. What are the weekend? Make it weekend. Okay? So if you go and check this out now, let me just execute this. Yes, if you can see that, I don't know if you can see the full one or not, because of my picture is climbing in the corner. So maybe I can do one thing, beer data dot columns, right? So you can see there is a data is there and there is a day is also there. So 2015, this is a little one is coming one. If you can see, 2015-01-02 was a Friday, right? So what you have done with the lambda function, you make those data or the day into the weekdays or weekends, right? So this is how we are going to do that. Now, thanks Rajesh, thank you so much. Take Reality, we don't take any payment for these sessions, right? Okay, so if you really like the video, then why don't you just like the like button and just do let us know in the comment section you are liking the video, and also subscribe Great Learning. And the second thing is, please do let us know in the comment for the new ideas you all have, right? So maybe we will try to come up with that as well. Okay, now what we are going to do, we are going to say, hey, we are going to use a Seaborn, right, to visualize our data. So in the Seaborn, what I said x will be x, we need to give the data. So x will be day and y will be consumo de cerveza. What is consumo? Is basically how much consuming you are beer, how much beer you are consuming, and here you are giving the data is equals to beer data. Let me just execute this. Okay, if you just look at this graph, you can see the Saturday and the Sunday has the most consuming beer, like if you can see in the graph. Lakshman, I will give you the answer later, what you are asking, right? So can you see this Saturday and Sunday has the most beer consumed, right, as it's a weekends. And if you look at the Friday, Tuesday also there is a little high, maybe after Monday the still is there. So yeah, Saturday and Sunday is the highest, right? So this is how you can understand that, okay, beer consuming in Saturday and Sunday is totally really high. Then we are going to use a machine learning concepts. Before that, we are going to drop data and day, right? Okay, and we are going to make it numeric. This data and day, we don't make this two is as a numeric, but other whatever we have, like maximum temperature, like according to temperature, if the temperature is too high, you don't want to have beer, right? Or what is the what is the other parameters can be to, yes, Kadikanti, I'm so sorry, Kadikanti, yes, weekend has, this is a week off, that is why it's more. Okay, right, now what we are going to do, you can see we are going to make it numeric because we are going to use all the data. Now what we are going to do, we are going to say train taste feed from sklearn. Sklearn is basically a scikit-learn where we are going to divide our data into training part and the testing part. In the training part, whatever the data we are going to show, we are going to use our train our model. Our model will not know about the testing part. So what we are going to do, to do that, we need to write scikit-learn.model-selection import train trace feed, right? From there, we are going to drop one column, that is the liters, right? According to the all the attribute, we are going to try to figure it out how much the liter, what will be beer consumption, right? So we are going to drop that particular column. So after that, X will have other all the attribute, Y will have only the beer consumption. What is the total beer consumption? So this is our label data. This will be your label, right? The what is the total consumption? From there, if you can see, we are going to make four parts. One is X-train, X-taste, Y-train and Y-taste, right? From there, we are calling a function called train-taste-pleat and we are giving our whole data, X, Y. And you said, I want 20% data to be test data and random state equals to 42. What is random set? Random set is basically, it can take any random data. There is no fixed point. First 80% will be your training and the last 20% will be your testing. Any data can be taken for training, any data can be taken for testing, right? This is why we use random state. Now we are going to import linear regression. As you know, the consuming beer liters can be a the continuous number that will not be 0, 1, true, false, right? So it will be linear regression. So we import linear model from linear regression, that is from scikit-learn, and we call linear regression function. Let me just execute that. Then we feed our model. Guys, I will answer your questions. Just give me, almost we came to end of the demo, right? So we are going to feed our data using X-train and Y-train, right? Okay, X-train and Y-train. So in that case, let me just feed means you are train your model with X-train, train value of X and Y. If you can look at here, we are going to predict the X taste. We are going to give only the attributes. According to that, it's gonna give you, okay, you gave me X taste. So if you can look at it, Y, great, right? This is the beer consuming array you got, 25.60, right? And if you look at the Y test. So what Y test will have? Y test will have the actual beer consumptions. Can you see our model is working really good? It's saying for this is 25.6. This is also giving 25.64. For the next one, it's giving 27. For the here, it's giving 31, right? So basically, X taste is like the prediction is basically going to give you what will be the beer consumption. And if you look at the score, I mean the accuracy with the new data, that is 74%. You can increase that as well, right? So this is our full demo. How can you predict beer consumption using machine learning? Pratik, no, we don't roll out any certification for the live sessions. Okay, so as we were talking about linear regression, so linear regression is basically a regression type where you can, the way we did, right, independent variable, dependent variable, and we talked about that. Now, as we already talked about the prediction of beer consumption, I hope you like this demo. And almost we came to the end of the session, and quickly I will answer your questions and wrap up today's session, right? So give me your feedback to the comment, not in the live chat, what you feel about this demo and what else you can invent in this demo, right? So I will give your answer and then we will wrap up today's session. Okay, why do we train and test? Main reason. So basically we need to train our model with the data, then we are going to give a new data to our model to understand how our model is working, right? Where we can deploy this model? Cloud. In the cloud, you can deploy using Flask or Django. Kashyap, thank you so much that you feel this the session is a helpful session. Why X-train? Why you? Okay. So Manish, is basically we are splitting our data in a four parts. One is for label, one is for other attributes. For label, we have train test. For the other attributes, we have train test. I almost came to the end and I don't think any other answers I left. And please do let us know in the comment section how you feel about this video and what else you want to learn from us. Okay, thank you so much guys. Thank you, bye bye. We will see you in the next session. Thank you guys.